So everything's on consent agenda this evening, so if there's something you'd like for me to pull off, let me know. The other quick update for the committee is the items for payroll are not listed on our agenda. So I'll read those.
Peter, can you pull the Gov HR?
Yeah. Got it. Anything else? Hey, we're not in a meeting yet. We're just gathering ourselves back here. Which one? I. Which one is she talking about? Oh, okay. We're on the same one. So we'll pull that too. At the request of Alderman Fleming. So I. Ready? Ready to go? All right. Good evening and welcome to the Monday, October 28th Administrative and Public Works meeting. My name is Alderman Braithwaite. We have a quorum. Is there a motion to approve the October 14th, 29 minutes?
Move approval.
Second.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any questions or comments? Seeing none, all those in favor of passing the minutes, please signify by saying aye.
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 Any opposed? Okay, motion carries. Public comment, we have one speaker signed up. Mr. Vasilko, 3 minutes. Got the time?
Mm-hmm. Get 45 minutes?
No.
Didn't think so. Okay. Well, I'm here to oppose a couple of things. First, opposing how this potential contract with Gov HR USA was passed in the Rules Committee of all places to bring to this committee. We know that Gov HR has at least 4 senior employees or owners that are previous ex-city employees. At the very least, that has the appearance of a conflict of interest, and is enough to select another firm. You should interview the other firms as recommended by staff to avoid what appears to be a very clear conflict of interest. You can't just pick a company because you know them or you like them. This is what happened at Robert Crown, and we ended up there spending $10 to $15 million more than we should have because you just picked somebody you liked. In this case, it's not about the money. It's about the principle. There are other firms that are more diverse that deserve the opportunity to be considered. I'm also here to speak against the Howard Ridge TIF. I don't think we know enough about that yet, and there should be more discussion. I'd like to speak against the issuance of the bonds for the Montessori school. What are the protections for the taxpayers should the school default? I'd like to hear somebody answer that question tonight, please. Does this limit us or impact us in any way, our overall bond rating? Should the city want to assist a more widely supported 501(c) organization? So I'd like the answer to that question. Lastly, I'm speaking against raising the threshold for spending without council approval from $20,000 to $25,000, which I think is a formula for more waste and possible graft. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We'll now take the consent calendar. Item A, which is not listed in the printed agenda. It's payroll September 30th through, and I'm going to say this slow just in case anybody wants to write now. It's not on your agenda. It's the payroll September 30th through October 13th, and that's in the dollar amount of $2,710,951.89, and the bills list October 29th in the dollar amount of $6,362,250.76. I did not check and see if this
it's
printed on the packet.
It's in the packet.
And also on the agenda.
It's not on the agenda, it's just on the, it's in the packet.
It's not on the agenda either. Okay.
Correct.
Did everyone get those numbers?
Yes, but I just have a question for the public and transparency.
Sure.
Since it's not on the agenda, where else could the public find
it? Will be in,
sorry.
It's on the it's in the packet.
So
I agree.
So we're transitioning to a new software system, and so with that, this was one of those issues where we had a glitch, and so moving forward, we will fix that for the next meeting. However, if you click on the actual item, you will see the detailed list of not only the agenda item, but the numbers, and that include payroll as well as bills list.
Thank you.
All right. I get it. All right, are there... Is there, I guess I keep going. At the request of Alderman Sufferton, we're gonna hold over item B. Item B is the contract award with GovHR for the city manager. I'd like to move item C, which is the first amendment, Howard's.
I think he's not holding it. He's just pulling it off consent agenda.
We're holding it over to, yeah.
Just pulling it off consent agenda.
Pulling it off. Good with that? All right. We're off to a little rocky start here. All right. Item C is the first Howard Tax Increment Financing TIF District. Are we going to discuss that at 7?
This is the summary. This is the public hearing. I'll be this after P&D. So this is accept and place on file.
Okay. So we're just going to accept and place that on file. Item D is the approval of the sole source agreement with Alphasur Power Systems to provide repairs and high lifts number 4 for natural gas engine. And that's not to exceed the dollar amount of $105,375. That's for action. Item E is resolution 90. Alderman Rainey.
Just to clarify,
yes.
I mean, we sort of glazed over the TIF issue on Howard Street. just so anybody listening knows, that there's going to be a public hearing at the council meeting.
Yes, I'm going to announce.
So this is sort of like before the horse, before the cart thing.
Very, very important, right? We're just placing it, the motion is placed on file, and we'll have that meeting after the TIF. I was going to announce that towards the end, but thank you for bringing that to our attention. Item E is the resolution 96-R-19, accepting grant awards to fund the Congregate Senior Meal Program at the Levy Center and Fleetwood Jourdain Community Center. Item F is resolution 97-R-19, appointing a director and alternative director of a solid waste agency. And then item G is resolution. Yes. Okay.
Who is that?
It's everybody. It's going to be the mayor.
It's the mayor.
The city, it's normally mayor, city manager, right?
That's correct.
Yeah.
It's the interim.
Okay.
She wants in.
Thank you for your comments, Alderman Rainey. All right, so item G is resolution 116-R-19, accepting a grant award for a long-term care and busman program. Would you like for me to read that, Alderman Rainey? All right, that's for action. Item H is resolution 117-R-19. It's an intergovernmental agreement with the Illinois Department of Healthcare and Family Services to provide greater cost coverage for ground emergency medical transportation provided to beneficiaries of the Illinois Medicaid plans and other similar state-administered medical programs. That's an intergovernmental agreement with the Illinois Department of Healthcare, and that's for action. Item I is ordinance 144-019. Approving the authorizing the assurance and sale not to exceed of series 2019A and series 2019B caliber. This is being, we're taking this one off too, right?
No, it's, we're gonna have the hearing, so I left it on the
You're
agenda because
okay
it's gonna be in the hearing.
Okay.
Yeah, I have questions.
You also have questions, got it. So again, this is the ordinance 144-0-19, approving the authorization and authorizing the assurance of sale not to exceed of series 2019A, series 2019B, Calvary, Caravalli Montessori School of the City of Evanston, Illinois, authorizing the execution and delivery of a bond loan agreement and other documents related thereto, authorizing the sale of said bonds on the Fifth Third Bank and approving related TEFRA hearing. Staff is recommending the City Council's adoption of this ordinance, approving the authorization of assurance of the sale not to exceed $3,925,000 aggregate principal amount of revenue bond series, again the 2019A, and $3,735,000 aggregate principal amount of revenue bond series 2019B of the City of Evanston for the benefit of Caravalli Montessori School, authorizing the execution and delivery of this bond and loan agreement and other documents related thereto, authorizing the sale of said bonds to Fifth Third Bank. All right.
That is going to be found on the public, so I'm making someone aware of it, just FYI.
Okay. Do we have someone from our AV looking into that? Okay. Folks, we'll just take a, since it's a short agenda after this, just a 2-minute reset to try to get the sound back on. And if somebody can just wave to me when we have it, that'd be great. Maybe we could hear some music.
Are you gonna discuss that item tonight? Item I?
Just said that, right.
Thank you.
it's back on. All right, we'll resume our meeting now that we have sound. We're now on item J, ordinance 20-0-19, amending the Title I, Chapter 10, City of Evanston Code of Ethics and Board of Ethics. The members of the Ethics Subcommittee recommend adoption of ordinance 20-0-19, amending the City Code Title I, Chapter 10, City of Evanston Code of Ethics and Board of Ethics and Board of Ethics Rules. That's for introduction. Item K is, we're going to take that off at the request of Alderman Fleming. Item L is ordinance 129-019, amending the City Code Section 1-17-1, purchase of goods and services. Staff recommends the City Council adoption of this ordinance, amending the City Code Section 1-17-1, purchase of goods and services. The ordinance will allow for the current purchasing threshold to
Peter, can you take that one off, please? Alderman Brinkley.
Yes, yes. The request of Alderman Fleming. And then item M is also been removed at the request of Alderman Fleming. That concludes our consent agenda. Is there a motion to approve?
Move approval.
Second.
It's been properly moved by Alderman Fleming, seconded by Alderman Simmons. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Ayes have it. We're going back to the beginning. Starting with Alderman Sufferton, would you like to take us through item B? Move it, please.
Sure. I move item B, which is the contract award with GovHR USA for the city manager executive recruitment. Staff requests City Council approve the interim city manager to enter into a contract with GovHR USA for the executive recruitment for the City of Evanston's next city manager in the amount of $23,500. One-third is due upon the acceptance of the proposal, one-third due when a list of candidates is forwarded to the city for consideration, and the remaining one-third is due when the recruitment is completed in 2020. Funding will be from the Human Resources Recruitment Fund with a remaining balance of $15,529. This is for action.
Second.
It's been properly moved and seconded.
I'm gonna vote no. I think we should look at other companies, and I'm just gonna point out that the argument that we should go with them because they know us well just doesn't seem to make a lot of sense. And they misspelled Jennifer Lynn's last name in their cover letter, and it's a three-letter last name. So I expect a greater attention to detail if my colleagues do vote to enter into a contract with them.
Noted. Seeing other, no further lights for discussion. All those in favor of passing item B, the contract to award GovHR USA for city manager executive recruitment, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
No.
No.
Okay, my so we have one of, right, so we have one of two options. Maybe if someone would consider just allowing this to go to council and continuing the discussion there.
I would just say that I would not, I mean, we had the discussion in council, I voiced my reasons there for opposing, so I don't need to do that again.
I'm pretty sure I did. Do you guys remember me having some concerns at council?
I had some concerns, but then we voted together.
Oh, I wasn't here that night. So my concerns remain.
Yep.
They were on public record. I definitely had some concerns.
Right.
I'm a no.
Which is fine. My suggestion would be to at least be able to discuss it in front of full council, if you are at least open to that. Alderman Rainey.
My suggestion would be that if there are these three votes here,
mm-hmm.
No, that we should at least acknowledge that and review all three proposals and, you know, move on from there. But I can tell you right now, I don't know all the people that are there. I don't know all of them that are involved in the search, but my interest in hiring them doesn't have to do because they know Evanston, but it's because sure. They are by far the most blue ribbon organization in in municipal search. So that's why I would support them. And also, they are reasonably priced because they just are. So I think let's do what several people have suggested and review as a group all three proposals and then take it from there.
Point of order. We voted. It failed. Why are we discussing it?
So we're discussing it for, I would think, the benefit of staff so they can hear comments.
Mr. Bose, once there's a vote and a result, is it appropriate to discuss?
Well, point of order.
Well, no, I didn't call. Did I call it to order?
Well, here's something interesting that could happen.
Right.
There are three of you who are voting no. There's a possibility that this vote, I mean, that there won't be a positive vote for anybody. I mean, because you might be the only three who are opposing this group. And this, that's, excuse me,
so,
might be, that might happen. So, you know, I think we have to look at it that way.
Sure.
But let's just let it lie for right now.
I think there are some good points that I would at least want. Is City Manager Storley?
No, she's not here.
She's not here.
So, Assistant City Attorney.
What are we still discussing?
No, we're still discussing.
So, is there a rule?
Five-member committee?
Let's move on.
Right. So, first of all, you made a suggestion, and I want to make sure that the suggestion falls into the right place because we don't have our city manager here. So, if you just want to kick the can, I'll kick the can, and then we'll come back and have a larger discussion at another time. Or we can provide direction to the staff so they can hear your concerns.
So
chocolate vanilla juice.
I provided direction at the Rules Committee. I believe maybe at some point, I'm not sure which meeting it was, but Alderman Simmons had similar direction. I can't remember Alderman Suffren's direction. Jen Lynn was here. Erica was here. I mean, folks heard the comments we had. It still came forward. I'm still a no. So I don't have any new direction to give staff. So we voted no. My assumption is it doesn't make it to council. And if HR wants to bring back the last three that were in the packet and have a discussion, I believe Alderman Fisk at some point asked to have a representative from the three top firms come forward, and that did not happen. So I would be happy to hear from them. I did not get the opportunity to do that.
I'm disappointed we've had this much further discussion after we made a vote on it. I mean, we haven't said anything new. And I don't know if the point is for us to change our vote at this point or what, but can we move forward?
Okay, perfect. Thank you. Item, next one is, I'm sorry, were you going to say something, Alderman Rainey? Alderman Rainey?
Which one are you on?
I'm moving to the next item, but are you good? Okay. Alderman Fleming, would you like to read item K?
Item K is staff recommends City Council adopt the ordinance 98-0-19, amending Chapter 31 to Title 3 of City Evanston City Code regulating collection boxes, which provides clearer guidance as to the size and location restrictions of collection boxes, as well as explicitly empowering the Director of Health and Human Services Department to make administrative decisions in conformance with the Code for Regulation of Collection Boxes for introduction.
Chair, second.
Second.
All right, so I just pulled this off because I wanted to clarify. This was a request that I made to staff after we had a collection box placed in the ward, which fit into code, but some neighbors did not care for. After that discussion, I read the code and realized that most all collection boxes that I knew of around town were not falling within our current code as written, which I think was just pretty old. So I asked staff to look at it and the Health and Human Services Department to make sure we had uniformity around collection boxes. So that's why this is up there. I wanted to give some, I can see if he wants to speak to it.
Good day, members of the committee. Ike Obo, Interim Director, Health and Human Services Department. Is there a specific question you have?
No, I just was clarifying for my colleagues why I asked for this to be cleaned up a bit.
Absolutely. The original language that we had for this code was ambiguous. and what we did was clean it up. There was some confusion in regards to fees, locations, and how many collection boxes that a location can have. So what this code now offers, the revised code, is cleaning up that language and making it more clear. Formally, it said that a collection box can't be in an inconspicuous area. So we actually made that clear to ensure that a collection box now will not sit within 3 feet of a property line, because what we felt inconspicuous meant defeated the purpose of the collection box ordinance, because how are you going to have a collection box and it's inconspicuous? So we make that language clearer now in this new revised ordinance that we created. And like I stated before, we also took a look at the fees, where it was very unclear if it's $150 for the entire year, which is, with this revised ordinance, is $150 per year and $75 per collection box. And also in the ordinance that we took a look at, the collection box, how many you can actually have. So each particular area that is licensed can only have one collection box in a former ordinance, but now we allow in up to 2 collection boxes, depending on those areas where there's high traffic, where so that we do not result in an issue where there's an accumulation of donations with it spilling all over the place. So that's pretty much where we arrive with this ordinance.
Thank you.
Seeing no other further lights for discussion, all those in favor of passing item K, please, for introduction, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Item L, Alderman Fleming.
I'm sorry, I didn't raise up. Staff recommend City Council adoption of Ordinance 129-0-19, amending City Code Section 1-17-1, purchases of goods and services. The ordinance will allow the current purchasing limit threshold requiring City Council approval to be raised from $20,000 to $25,000 for introduction.
Is there a second?
So my only question here is, it's only $5,000. I would like to know maybe mid-year how many purchases we have had and what they were, going from this threshold, if we go back to the $25,000. So just as the memo laid out how many there were. It doesn't make me a huge difference, although, the memo just states this is what other cities are doing. And I think I would like just a little more, not for this one, but for future memos, for me to just be told we're doing this because other cities are doing it isn't necessarily, a convincing rationale for me. So for this one, I'll approve it, but I would like a report maybe mid-year just to see where we are on these purchases.
And just as a point of information, Alderman Fleming, I also asked City Manager about it, how many actual bills on average. So the difference is 3.
Right, but going in the future.
No, I get it. I just think you raised a very good question, and so because I asked a similar question, it's only 3 out of everything that we vote on.
You mean in previous years?
So if we looked at last year, and if we were at a 25,000 threshold, the number of items that we passed, either above or under, the variance is 3.
Right. No, I saw that in the packet. Yeah. Yes. So I would like to just know that number for next year. Not a big deal.
Okay. Got it. All right. All those in favor of passing item L, which is for introduction, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? That motion carries as well. Alderman Fleming, item M.
Staff recommends City Council adoption of Ordinance 124-0-19, directing the City Manager to offer the sale of vehicles owned by the City through public auction at Northwest Municipal Vehicle Auction, being sponsored by America's Auto Auctions on or about Tuesday, November 12, 2019. These vehicles have been deemed to be surplus as a result of a new vehicle purchase being made into the service, or vehicles that had to be taken out of service for safety reasons with the intention of eventual replacement. The interim City Manager requests suspension of the rules and introduction and action at the October 28th City Council meeting.
Second.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Alderman Fleming.
Do we need to vote on the suspending the rules?
It's.
Yep. Okay. Yeah, I'm fine. I just want to make sure.
Read.
Okay.
And notice. So
I
have to.
I put this one off. I asked the interim city manager about this. There were a couple on here that are cars with pretty low mileage. And my question was, is there something that prohibits us, or have we thought about making those family size or sedans available for purchase by city staff or even people in the community? So I'm not sure how much we would get for, and I don't have it in front of me, sorry, but I think there's like a couple of Ford Freestars or something another, you know, how much we might, you assume we might get at auction, and if the price is reasonable enough for us to maybe offer them to city staff before we'd send them to auction.
Chairman, members of the committee, Sean Cholik, Division Manager of Facilities and Fleet Management. That's not something that we've considered, but it's something that we can definitely look into. I don't know what kind of pricing we would get back on those vehicles, but we can look into it and take them off if you'd like.
I mean, I don't necessarily need to take these off. I know we have these scheduled to go, but it would be, I would love for you to come back at another time and give us an idea of roughly what we get for something that could be used as just a family car. I know some of these are these huge work trucks.
Sure.
What we get at auction, if that's something that we, you know, if we know they're going to auction potentially, if there's something we want to offer to our staff or, you know, a resident in our community who needs a reliable, low-cost car.
Yes.
If we're going to get the same amount or a comparable amount that we would get at auction.
Yeah, I would imagine that it'd be comparable to what we get at auction. We've also done donations in the past, so that's something we can consider if it's, you know, something that the council wishes us to pursue.
Okay, well, if you can come back another time with an idea of what those prices kind of range around, that would be great.
Sure.
Thank you.
And not to limit it to the passenger vehicles, but the work vehicles as well for a small business community that might need access to work trucks.
Sure, for pickup trucks and such.
Yes. Thank you.
We can look into that. Thank you. Mm.
You said you've done that.
All right. All those in favor of passing item M, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. All right, that's it. So two quick announcements. First, our planned development meeting will start on time at 6:45 right here in council chambers. And then the next announcement, we will have a public hearing later to follow the P&D meeting regarding the Howard Ridge TIF. That is a public hearing. And the Care Valley bonds. Yes, thank you for that. All right, is there a motion to adjourn?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Our planned development meeting will start in 15 minutes. Thank you. Mm-hmm.